The places that I go to are primarily in the southern hemisphere. I'm leaving for Antarctica in a week or two, and it'll be my 16th trip to Antarctica. I look at sedimentary rocks, and it'll give you a history of what happened at any one spot on the Earth's surface through time. The period that I'm most interested in is the Permian period. There were lots of large ice sheets that were on the southern continents known as Gondwana land, and then they disappeared very suddenly. So it serves as an ancient deep time analog for the possible climate change that may be happening to Earth in the future. Antarctica, once you've been there, you either love it or hate it. If you love it, you'll spend the rest of your life trying to get back there. It's magnificent, it's awe-inspiring, it's an alien landscape. It's absolutely quiet, there are no sounds once you get away from a base. During the summer, it's daylight 24 hours a day. The air is crystal clear, there are no smells except the smells you create, and the smells you create, sometimes you can smell them 5 miles away. I do take students there. I've taken both undergrads and graduate students and a postdoc. We live in tents. We're out on the rocks. We're usually in the high mountains or on nunataks close to the polar plateau. So we've got to endure all the elements. We do all of our cooking. We melt our own water. We don't have heat. The heat is the sun. Even if you compare Wisconsin winter to Antarctica, it just isn't comparable. The most fun is solving the scientific questions. They're like mysteries. You have to put the clues together to figure out what happened and the history for a particular place. That occurs while you're in Antarctica, but it also occurs when you're back at UWM in the lab. I'd like to continue going, and I'd like to continue working as a professor until I'm 70. So I'd like to get there at least 20 times, maybe 25 times.